Recently, I have gone through the Power BI community website and I have seen a question like the user requested to show the zero value when there is no transactions on the particular date or on that particular category. So I thought to make a video about that. It's an interesting topic, so watch till the end to know in detail about it. Hi, I'm Muhammad Adnan and welcome to my channel Like 18. And here in this channel, we discuss a lot about Power BI, Power Automate, Power Apps, SQL, YouTube, and a lot more to come. If you're new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Now let's get started. So before digging into it, let's have a look at the data. Basically, I have the region table, and sales by region. The region has the region name, north, south, east, and west. That's my favorite. And the region sales, if you look at the transaction date we have and region and sales and index is just for number reference. So as you can see, on 1st of Jan, it's only 3. On 2nd, we have 4. On 3, we have 4. And on 4, we have 3. So it means there is one region transaction is not there on during 1st and 4th of Jan, just as an example scenario. So now let's build from the scratch itself. So for the transaction date, I will add as a slicer. So it should be only transaction date and it should be the slicer. I need this to be a list. And let's increase the font size a bit, going to formatting option and then text size. Instead of 10, I prefer to be 20. Okay, now let's add a table. Here I'm going to add the transaction date. It has to be a regular date. And then the sales amount. The sales amount I directly taken from the table. Just step by step we'll go here. And also I want to increase the font size to good feel, and here the text size instead of 10 it should be 20. All right. So basically, if I select Jan 2nd for an example, I get all the region data here. So north, south, east, and west. So when I select Jan 4, it gives me only 3. But the requirement is whatever the date selection is, but I need to show all the 4 regions. If there is no sales on that day, then it has to show as 0. So the first stage I thought to make the sales amount as a measure. So what I have written here, the sales amount measure common. It's basically this is how we write, right? Sum of sales amount. So what I did, I just added this sales amount instead of this. I removed this one and I'm adding this. Even after adding this, the result is not satisfied one. So what I thought to create a separate table for the region. So let's take an example of region from the master table, because in master we have all the 4 records. So let's add up here. Even after adding that, I didn't get that result. So, and then what I thought to add here is to write one more measure, that is the sales amount. Here it's just a small tweak. What I did is sales amount, sum of sales which was there earlier plus 0. This is the only addition I have added here. By just doing that and adding the value here, now it gives me 4 region data. Even the north east shows as 0. This is cool, right? So it's not a stop here. So we have a few more things to know about what in detail it is. So now this is actually coming from the master table. So what if I remove this and bring it from the fact table itself? See, The result is surprising, right? So the reason behind that is we have separate table, and in that table we have north, south, east and west. And here on this date for this transaction table, we don't have those informations. We have only three records for this region. So that's why it's not showing up here. So it is good to create a master table whenever it is. So that only I also recommend to create a separate date table if you're filtering it on by region and it will not show up for a particular date. So for that purpose, you have to create a separate date table and you have to make one-to-many relationship with the sales by region table. And if you do so, then you will get the result for all the days. So for that purpose, I want to bring the region name from the master table. So just delete this. I have deleted this and adding up here. Now you can see all the four regions and with the zero value as well. Now you may wonder why I have added this one as well, right? So even though this also works fine, there is no issue with this calculation. So just to give a workaround, you can also do by this one. Like if the value, which is the sum of sales by region, is blank, then I need the zero value, or else I need the sum of sales by region. I click commit now. This will also behave and works in the same way how we had done on the top. Sum of sales by region plus zero. See, look at the result. So this is how you can able to extract the information by region even though there is no sales on that particular date or no sales on that particular region. So whatever it is, you can get this kind of information by creating two things. One is it has to be a star schema like the fact and dimension model, or at least the snowflake schema, and also you need to write this kind of measure. So by doing these two things, you can show the values even though there is no record for that particular date or region. If you found this video useful, just hit the like button. And if you're visiting first time to this channel, or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. But make sure you turn on the notification on your devices. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it on the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.